Welcome to a new episode in creating a trance track for beginners in Ableton Live 10. So we have a lot of components down already, but in this episode I hope to finalize all of the other contents we are going to put in our track. And first off, I want to start with an arpeggiator. So I add a new track. Oops, I recolor an already existing track. I think the same mistake I did last time. Not so clever for me. I add a new MIDI track. And I will go and add an arpeggio. And for this I'm going to use a white plug. The white plug from the wavetable. So I'm going to search for it. Wavetable synth white plug. My MIDI push controller is not working at the moment. Let's wait for it to restart. Okay. The scale. We are working in G major. Okay, so I'm going to put a MIDI effect on it, and of course the arpeggiator, and I'm going to use the classic up down. I transpose in the major key according to the key of G. I think two steps is alright. 1/16th notes. Gating a bit lower. Okay, and now I'm going to put in some notes in this one. Of course, I'm going to put in notes according to the G major scale. So as I mentioned last time, in order to make this easy, I first create the C major scale, which are all the white keys. And then I drag this to the G, and then I can copy this. Because if I do it this way and I press Alt, I now only see keys in the key of G major. Change the grid size. And I wanted two bars here, so let's change this to two bars. Why is this still gray? This is gray, I'm not sure why. Maybe because this is not okay. It was gray because the clip in this transport view was not large enough to show it. Okay, so let's put in some notes. It doesn't matter that much which note because we are going to arpeggiate it. But of course it's nice if it's sounding all right. Let's play and solo this. Let's call this ARP1. ARP1. If I stretch this out. Thank you. like this gap here, so move that upwards. I think it sounds okay. Let's call this arp. And I add an I'm sorry for that. I had to sneeze. Okay, I will put I'm sorry. Okay, so I'm going to put an EQ8 because I want to cut off the low end. Something I always do, because again, maybe I didn't tell you, but in all of these tracks we have this low end, and if you don't cut off that low end, it stacks up and it will get huge. So it's a good habit to always remove the low end of the tracks. Of course, in the sub bass you want the low end, so you're not going to cut the low end from the sub bass, but in the other tracks you usually want to cut off the low end. I'm going to add a second arpeggio. I just duplicate this track. I think I can do that, because the only thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change the sound of it. And I'm going to use the recta plug, the recta plug. It's in okay, the recta plug. Let's hear how all of this sounds together. I mean those two arpeggios. What I'm now doing is I'm soloing two tracks at the same time. You can do this on the Mac by using the command and clicking on the S, and then you can solo multiple tracks. I'm not sure how you can do this on a Windows PC, but that will be something like Control Alt, I suppose. But on the Mac, it's the Command key. I'm going to group these two arpeggios because I want to put on some ping pong delay, reverb and the compressor. So I group these tracks. R group, ping pong delay, audio effects, and then ping pong delay. Put up some reverb. A sidechain compressor. We'll be right back. okay, I think this sounds great. And what we are going to do now is to add some pads. And for the pad, sorry that I was thinking and looking at my template project, because the thing is with the pads, we are going to put up a chord progression again, and I want to look at the pluck, because I can follow the same pattern as the pluck. Okay, so we are going to add the pad, we are going to add it below this one, insert MIDI track, pads group, or not a group immediately, insert MIDI track, okay, pad. We're going to add multiple pads, pad 1. The first pad is the concrete wave cave, concrete wave cave. And what I'm going to do is going to add the MIDI. I just copy over the MIDI from the plug, because I'm going to use the same kind of chords there. So let's rename this to pad, and I make it, I can actually click here, assign track color to clips. Okay, we're going to make this longer. Let's start it over here, make this a very long pad sound. This starts over there. Let's make a bit shorter sound. This goes there. And of course, I need to delete these. And then this becomes very long. That's a bit too long. So let's make this a bit longer than this. And then this is 2 bars. Well, can be, I think. Let's. Let's listen to it. I think it actually sounds okay, so I will leave it like this. Then the second pad is the perception pad, insert, or I can better duplicate this track again, because the only thing I'm going to change is the sound. Perception pad, perception pad. Let's listen. Sound. I will group these because I want to create a pad group. Pad group and lower the sound a lot of these pads. Okay, I'm actually going to add a third pad, which is the shapes and sauce pad. I duplicate this pad again, I rename it, and look for the shapes. What I also actually show you in this tutorial is how good the wavetable synth is, how many presets there are, but also how versatile it is. I mean, I can create pads, bass, acid lines, plugs, all kinds of sounds are possible with the wavetable synth. So I think that's great. Let's listen to it, how it sounds right now. And then the fourth pad. The fourth pad. And that's the mind lift pad. I think this sounds okay. Then we do some processing on it. And what I want to do is to cut some frequencies, mainly the low end again, of course. EQ8. I'm also cutting a bit of the high end, because when it plays with the lead sound, I want the high end to be shining on the lead and not on the pad. So now we finally have come to the lead sound. And I think I'm going to use the same chord progression, but now I'm going to put this into some kind of nice melody. And of course this will not be very easy. If we look at the plug bus, we already had a progression in chords, but now we have to be a bit more creative. So what I'm going to do now is to add a track for the lead sound. The lead one. And I will also okay, I forgot something. I also have a sub pad. Let's put that in first. Yeah, bit stupid of mine, but I also have a sub pad. And the sub pad, so I add a MIDI track. The sub pad is actually the lower notes of the pad. Rename it as sub pad. I was going too fast. I also have to do the sub pad. So what I can do is copy the pad. And I just keep the lowest notes of the progression. Also, I probably lower the notes one octave, because otherwise they are a bit high. I use the castaway patch, castaway, all results, the castaway patch. And let's listen to it. I think it sounds great. And I will put on the AQ8 now. And I will cut now some of the high end and not of the low end because it's a sub pad. And let's sound everything together. Okay, this sounds okay. This really sounds good. So we finally can start with the lead. For the first lead sound, I want to use the analog flute lead. Analog flute lead. You can't find it, but maybe here. So lead one, the analog flute lead. Sounds like this. Okay, so I can't play actually, but I did play on my push, but of course it didn't sound that great. I'm going to what am I going to? I think I will make the plug a bit similar to the plug. I make the lead similar to the plug. Will not be a very good lead, but I think the track in the end overall sounds will sound acceptable for a beginner's track. Okay, I want to introduce you to a new concept which I want to use in this lead, and that's namely the concept of inversion. I can invert these chords by moving the lowest note an octave higher. So this chord, if I move the G3 to G4, then it's in first inversion. I actually want to use that concept to create a bit of variation in the pluck sound. Also, I want to make the lead a lot faster. So what I'm probably gonna do is to make the notes a bit shorter because I want a fast lead. But of course, this is already quite fast, so I have to see what I'm going to do about that. Let's put on the 132. For example, we can do something like this to make it sound faster. Let's solo this lead sound and play. I think it sounds okay that I play this a bit faster, so I can copy that concept. So let's move the C4 one octave higher. And I can make it shorter and copy it. And I think this part is okay. Then let's make this one also repeating fast. And let's move this up. Let's move this all both up. Okay, what you see now in this lead is that all nodes, it seems kind of horizontal. There's no much gaps in high or low frequencies. I think it's better if there is a bit of a larger gap in frequency. So we probably have to move some things upwards. What we also could do is make the beginning chord very low. We put the G3 to G4 and then we make the entire thing an octave lower. Yeah, that sounds very low. We can actually make this invert this a second time and then make this also an octave lower. Now it's really looking like it's going upwards steadily. And then this one, also an inversion. And these go down slowly. Put this one over here. And this one over there. So now we have some upwards and downwards movements. Let's play it. Sound better if it's moving upwards all the time. So what we could do is we move this one down so it's very low and this one goes up again. So now we have a continuously upwards movement, only one time we step backwards downwards. Okay, I think it sounds acceptable. It's not great, but we can certainly use it for our track. Yeah, I think actually that when we had the upwards and downward movement like this, that it was sounding better. And maybe we have to put in some extra fast notes over here. Over here. Like this. Okay, I think this really sounds better, so we keep it like this. And I put an EQ on this one. An EQ 8. I low cut it. And the highs, I make it a bit, give it a slight boost. Okay, we're going to layer this. So I have actually a second lead, which is the after fade, is it called? After fade. All results. Okay, of course. I duplicate this track. Rename it. And I called this after fade. Let's listen to it. Which is called diagraph persona. Diagraph persona. Duplicated. Diagraph persona. That's a gritty sound. It sounds sometimes a bit low, so what we can try is to add a MIDI effect and plus 12 we add it to every lead and just see if that sounds better. What it does is it adds 12 semitones to each note, so I don't need to change the actual MIDI pattern. I can just put in this MIDI effect. Let's listen again. I think it sounds good on everything except for lead 2. So let's listen it again. Sounds better now. Let's add a ping pong delay. So audio effects and ping pong delay.
Thank you.
still a bit of a weird lead melody, I think. But for the sake of the tutorial, I think we keep it like this. And we will go on with it. And in the next tutorial, I will start with the arrangement of all these elements, because we are done with creating all the elements for the track. So thank you all for watching, and if you have comments, leave them down below. And thank you all very much, and I hope to see you in the next episode. Bye bye.